Look, I don't know why everyone's so down on the Canucks right now. You could be living in Florida, where it occasionally rains harder than this.
But seriously, people, think how spoiled you've been. You've been to a Stanley Cup final, and could well have been to more. You've had one guy lead the NHL in scoring and be named the league MVP, and you've had another guy who looks exactly like the first guy lead the NHL in scoring and be voted by its players as their MVP. You had 8 pretty darn fine seasons from one of hockey's best goalies, who also happened to win you an Olympic gold medal. And this city doesn't exactly have a tradition of Olympic gold medal winning goalies who've also been among the best in the game for years. You can mock the President's Trophy all you want, but for 2 years, for 164 games, no one was better. In European soccer, this makes you conquering heroes. In North American hockey, this means you can't win the big one. So now the Canucks suck. Well, boo-hoo. Imagine being in Nashville, in Buffalo, on Long Island, or in Calgary. Or how about in Florida, where they promised many championships to come upon introducing Roberto Luongo yesterday, except you know they're damn liars. Is this as bad as it's going to get? Maybe not. But if the Canucks haven't plummeted to near rock bottom, they're close. And from there, you can usually only go up. Will the Sedins ever regain their old glory? Who knows? Will Ryan Kessler ever smile again? Who cares? Will Bo Horvat and Hunter Shinkarik help? Here's hoping. Will a couple of Swedish storks make us forget those other guys? Maybe, maybe not. I'll only say this. It's been a great run. A fun run. And now it's uglier than The Walking Dead. So embrace it, people. And don't forget your umbrella.